The reason I became a specialist was that my mentor in India and Australia always used to say that a specialist is end of line. The diagnosis that you're going to make is going to stick to the patient forever. And I quite like that end of line feeling, hence I became a specialist. My biggest asset is that I can get work done. I see myself as a doer. I don't get bogged down by small issues. I work on a dictum that vision without execution is hallucination. While vision is important, I want to get score the runs, get work done on the ground level. That's my biggest asset. I have the capacity of breaking down a complex project into smaller steps and get them done. There would be three major influences that I would say have shaped my career. One was my father, who always asked me to follow excellence and then success will come by itself. My second would be my mentor in India, who always asked me to stay modest. And the third would be my mentor in Australia, who asked me to pursue diagnostic accuracy. The biggest challenge would be that I had to move with my young family first from India to Canada, where I did my initial research, and then had to move again with the family from a really cold country like Canada to Australia, where I wanted to do my PhD with Professor Chang. That has been by far the biggest challenge for me. Besides my mentors, my wife Shweta certainly is a big influence in my life as well. She's the one who keeps me grounded, and my two girls, Naisha and Savannah. When I go back home after a busy day at work, those are the girls that I go home to, and that refreshes me to seek challenges and to handle the challenges for the next day. My experience with the college has always been very good. The exam process, the training process, the college was very supportive, and hence I automatically gravitated towards having a bigger role at the college. I have been the director of pediatric education at the Queensland Children's Hospital for now 7 years, and hence when the opportunity came to become part of the higher committees like the PCHD, I took it on board. And more recently, I was honored to be given the opportunity to become the president-elect of the PCHD at RSCP. And I'm quite enjoying that role as well. I always tell my trainees to look at the bigger picture, to get their hands dirty, to score the runs, to be doers, and not just procrastinate that will be done later. I always tell them to look and to break a big project into smaller steps, so that slowly but surely steps can be taken and a bigger project can be achieved. There are a few things that I feel I'm proud of. My PhD in children with non-cystic fibrosis, I'm really proud of that achievement. We defined an exacerbation in bronchiectasis. I always say that research and publications make you immortal. The Kapoor et al. Feeling, the Kapoor's definition, I'm fairly proud of that. Having been elected as the president-elect for the pediatric and child health division of the RACP, I'm very proud of that achievement. And then there are smaller things that make me very proud. The one certificate that's on my desk is the Mentor of the Year award that the Junior Doctor Society gave me. And more recently, I got the award for the best selfie taker. So I'm very proud of those small achievements. I think I'm still very young to have stamped my legacy on this world. So I have lots to achieve. I'm going to use this current 3 or 4 years as the president-elect to establish some form of legacy. What I've already achieved, I believe the Queensland Basic Pediatric Training Network, which has been established and running well for the last 5 years, would come very close to what I identify as my current legacy.